Greetings, fellow pilots. I'm Ryan Munsch, and welcome to the Copilot Flight School series from Microsoft Copilot for Security. During the series, we'll go over what Copilot for Security is and how to effectively use it to protect your organization at AI speed. The series is designed to be a level 200 series viewed sequentially and is most effective if you've had some exposure to Copilot, have an instance available to you, and have watched some of our other video content. So, what is Copilot for Security and why should you use it? Security is complex and requires highly specialized skills to face the challenges of today. Often, for those reasons, many of the people working to protect the organization work in silos, isolated from other business functions. Further, enterprises are highly fragmented environments with esoteric systems, data, and processes, all of which take a tremendous amount of time, energy, and effort just to do the day-to-day. Copilot for Security is a cloud-based AI-powered security platform which is designed to address these challenges by redefining what security is and how security gets done. It enables analysts, no matter their discipline or expertise, to operate more effectively in a security context, thus revolutionizing the way people in organizations approach cybersecurity. But before I go into the ins and outs of the platform, let's go over what generative artificial intelligence, or GAI, is. Generative AI and associated applications are a subset of different data sciences. While it's probably the type of data science you've heard about, it's not possible without underlying and supportive elements from deep learning, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. Let's start with an example to help explain some underlying elements. As humans, understanding our world is predicated upon how we process, learn from, and retain data. Computer systems are the same way, but traditionally haven't been able to do that without human help and a lot of data science. This is especially true when it comes to large amounts of data from a multitude of sources or the fundamental challenge in cybersecurity. To illustrate, let's consider a case where we need to identify dogs based on pictures. We would create a model used to identify a golden retriever from a picture. But when faced with a picture of a Irish cream retriever or Labrador retriever or a double doodle, which yes, is a thing, go ahead and bing it, it would necessitate individual models for identification. We would have to scale this for each and every type of dog. This mirrors the challenges faced in security and use of what this example represents. Individual, supervised, or even unsupervised models have trouble scaling collective understanding. A few years ago, a research paper put forward the concept of a transformer, which uses vector relationships to identify meanings of words through proximity and ordering relative to other words. Consider our dog example. A dog is something through observed positioning and language could be closely associated with Fluffy, or maybe really closely associated with Cute. And a close collective pairing would be a dog that is both Fluffy and Cute. Our dog, perhaps after playing in a few puddles, could be Dirty, but that's a less frequent association. And similarly, so would it be with being Dirty while still pulling off Cute and Fluffy. The transformer model architecture uses proximity to develop predictive associations of words, and that can be used to understand larger patterns and concepts. With the release of the transformer, the OpenAI folks had a pretty brilliant hypothesis. They bet that if they took vast amounts of data, applied a transformer against it, associations could be made without any input or training or supervision of learning. And the more data given to a transformer, the more accurate and comprehensive it would be. It would also, by extension, produce more associations, understand concepts, and convey complex subjects without the need for an inordinate amount of machine learning models. This, known as a foundational model, became the basis for what is known as large language models, or LLMs. The last element was to create a natural language interface into the data, and that's where the LLM comes in. It provides an interface into the foundational data through natural language, So sure enough, with a large language model and using the data assembled to train it, we could ask simple questions and receive profound results back by generating new content. Perhaps how to give a dog a bath to ensure it is both cute and fluffy again. There are other applications of LLMs that can result, depending on their training data and encoding, to handle different data types. This is referred to as multimodal LLMs. This simply means different data types can also be part of the training and generative output capability of the model. So if our prior LLM happened to incorporate pictures, it could identify the type of dog based on the picture, determine if it's dirty, and potentially even pair bathing instructions for our dog. The final element then is to cover the nature of interaction with the LLM and how architecture supports it. With the advent of generative AI, it's ushering in a paradigm shift for how interactions with systems, which now can be conversational in nature. And in holding a conversation with a system, a need arises for continuity and advancement of dialogue as to produce an outcome or arrive at a satisfactory answer to a line of questioning. One might want to ask, based on instructions received for bathing, how it might differ based on the type of dog, allergy, health considerations, or availability of bathing supplies. Creating memory or being a stateful AI system also helps with that. Generative AI is really good at producing net new content from its training data, but what are some of the limitations and how does this relate to security? LLMs are resource intensive. For OpenAI to produce its latest GPT-4 model, it leveraged one of Microsoft's supercomputers, in fact, the fifth largest in the world. And it took weeks of time and millions of dollars to train the model against trillions of input parameters. As inferred, producing net new models is either an expensive prospect or compromises are made with the number of parameters against the scope of training. Methods such as fine-tuning, which are suggested learning model amendments, help with specialization but introduce computational cost and latency each time it is used. This all makes LLMs difficult to use in specialized applications without a lot of other components, which we'll talk about in the next episode. The other limitations of LLMs come with its throughput of data. With each natural language lookup, it is sent to an LLM in a tokenized form, which the model can understand and relate to its training architecture. Similarly, the output generated is also tokenized in responding back to the input query. What this means is that each model has a token limit, and subsequently, LLMs are not good at analyzing vast amounts of data. Instead, LLMs need help from systems running machine and deep learning models to generate insights or smaller subsets of data for analysis. This is why in cybersecurity, there is no one LLM that can operate by itself. One of my hopes is that by the time you complete flight school, you walk away with an understanding of just how unique Copilot is and how much the platform was inspired by the problem it is trying to solve. There are a lot of things Copilot can do, but let's start with some of the things it isn't. To start, it's not ChatGPT, meaning it doesn't invoke ChatGPT APIs, learn from your prompts, or leverage an internet training dataset. Copilot is also not a single LLM or monolithic cyber-trained model. Unlike what you may build in Azure AI, it is not an AI primitive service and isn't a stateless architecture. Copilot for Security is a compound AI system or AI platform that is stateful and extensible. It uses AI orchestration to combine multiple AI components and GPTs, which are GPTs stripped of their training data. The data it reasons over belongs to the customer or to Microsoft, and any intellectual property used to produce works are protected by Microsoft's indemnity clause. It is finally a system designed from the ground up with responsible AI principles, otherwise known as RAI. Responsible AI principles are the foundational practices that guide people as they design safe and fair AI systems. Responsible AI is at the core of Copilot, and we place a lot of importance on incorporating those principles into every facet of the platform. Microsoft first outlined its responsible AI framework publicly in June of 2016, and it has long guided our approach. In 2019, we created an Office of Responsible AI and launched our first set of standards that put these best practices into actionable guidance for our engineering teams and our industry. We released an updated framework in June of 2022 and published the governing AI blueprint in May of 2023. We believe that the development and deployment of AI must be guided by the creation of an ethical framework. So we set out our view that there are six core principles that should guide the work around AI, and we operationalize these at scale. In later videos, we will show you how our AI emerges in various elements of the Copilot platform. Thanks for watching the first video in the Flight School series. We hope this has you excited for what is to come. You're well on your way to becoming an ace. We'll catch you next time, pilots.